Let's connect the Nikon P1000 to a smartphone application. So let's enable on the phone, for example, the Wi-Fi so that we can have internet. Open the Google Play Store and search for SnapBridge. SnapBridge search. Install that one. SnapBridge is installed. Let's open it. Allow SnapBridge to access photos and media on your device. Let's allow it. Getting info. Download image data for a new product. Okay. Download is complete. Okay. Accept the application license, privacy policy, and start is available. Welcome to SnapBridge. Click on connect to camera. Turn on Bluetooth. Allow Bluetooth. From this list, we should select the Nikon Coolpix P1000, which is here in the Coolpix P1000, so tap on those numbers. You will next be prompted to allow access to location services. Okay, so while using the app, it needs to enable the location of the phone. To use this app, enable location data on your device. Okay, so swipe down, Wi-Fi is enabled, Bluetooth is already enabled, and we need to enable location. So tap on location. So it needs three things: location, Wi-Fi, and Bluetooth. So Coolpix once again. Select connect to smart device on the camera network menu. So power on the camera. Press the menu button. Come here to the third icon, which is the network menu. Go to the right. Airplane mode is on, so that is blocking the communication, so we need to set it to off. Airplane mode is off. Now when it's off, now it says select connect to smart device. Connect to smart devices here. So click on that one. It says searching. Okay, let's go back on the phone. And voila, it's already there. There's a number which ends with 382. 382 is there also. Connecting to camera. Please wait. If this is not working, it freezes, then power off the camera and power it on again. So to that 382, which was mentioned here before, it's trying to connect and it gives a passkey type of password, 636636. So it's the same one. So click on pair on the phone and press the camera OK button. OK, it says establishing connection. Your camera and smart device are connected. Pairing complete. Connected to camera. Tap on OK. Enable or disable auto download, clocks, or location data. Tap the display. Check the camera connection status. Tap to display additional information. So there's a Bluetooth icon. Tap again. View images download from the camera. So that's up there. Link to Nikon Cloud. That's the third icon up there. Now we have here download pictures. Those are the pictures which were taken by the camera. Enable Wi-Fi, okay. Connecting to camera, searching for devices. Connect to device, yes, connect, the same 382. Connected. And here are a few pictures that I just took before using that camera. Let's go back. So download pictures is showing the pictures taken by the camera. That is here in the middle. Remote photography. Tap on that one. Switching to remote mode. Connected. Now the phone is connected to the camera and you can use the W and the T for wide and tele. That is, you can zoom in or zoom out. I'm holding the button and the lens is jumping, so it's not continuous. So you can take a look from this angle. I'm holding the T and the lens is extending. There's friction below there. And now the W. So the image on the phone is slightly jumping, it's not too fluent. And the only option you have here is the photo, so you cannot take any videos. So we just took a picture and it's there. We can zoom in, take another picture. downloading picture. The entire screen here, it's a focusing area. It always focuses into the center, so it doesn't matter where I tap, in which corner, it's always focusing there. You cannot modify those values. You can preview the picture, you can delete the picture. By the way, it's 1440 by 1080, so it's downloading a smaller version of that file. You can delete it. Delete image, yes. Delete that one, yes. We have the battery percentage of the camera, and to the phone it will download a 2 megapixel image. We have a gear icon here, self timer, 3 seconds. Now it will count down, 2, 1, and now it captured the photo. You cannot use the screen while the app is connected. By the way, you can turn off location and Bluetooth and use just the Wi-Fi, and the program is still working. So let's remove the timer, disable the timer, back, live view, you can disable it, take a picture. Okay, let's go back. SnapBridge is asking to turn on Bluetooth. You can deny it. Enable location on your device. Just click OK and it's not turning it back on, neither the Bluetooth. So just Wi-Fi is enough to communicate so that the two devices will radiate less. Wi-Fi, there's an active Wi-Fi connection. Switch to Bluetooth to use auto download location data or clocks. Yes. Now, when it's using Bluetooth, these are not available. Out of camera signal range. So to connect it back, I need to re-enable the location and the Bluetooth. And now remote photography is available. Connect it. Searching for devices. Connect to device, the same 382. Connect. Connected. Switching to remote, and the image is being sent to the phone, and I can use it again. Now let's start from the beginning. If I disable all those, location, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, and turn off the camera and close the application also, let's start from the beginning. I will start the SnapBridge app. Let's power on the camera, turn on Bluetooth, turn on location and turn on Wi-Fi. Location, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi. Yes, allow, remote photography, enable Wi-Fi, searching for devices. So I left the airplane mode off inside the camera. That means the connections are not turned off. Airplane mode is the blocking feature. So let's connect. And it's working again. Focus. Not focusing. It's too close. It's not capturing the picture either. Why? Because it's too close. Focus. Picture. So if it's too close, it's not taking the picture. I have just 3 pictures. No out of focus pictures. Okay, so that's the SnapBridge app for Nikon P1000. To conserve a little bit of battery power, let's go back to the menu, to the left, down to network menu, to the right, and airplane mode, set it to on. Now it's blocking the wireless communications.